Cut out past you, Andrew.
I went behind, mate. Hit me. Past Bedsy, if you did that, I used to throw it back at him.
So, the ball.
Yeah.
So, tonight, as we saw, there was a lot... Look, the conditions, they weren't friendly. Mm-hmm. And you spoke in commentary about whether the fact there should be maybe a dry weather ball or wet weather ball.
Day ball.
Day ball.
Yes.
How would they do that? And
well, this ball here is perfect for a day ball. And you have a look at the dimples or the niffles, whichever you want to say. And these ones here, they're quite small. Now,
are we talking about your hands or...?
Yeah. Look at those little Cessnock hands.
Effective, though.
But at night, and during the day, you can catch it and just throw it, which doesn't sound like much, but it gives you that fraction of a second where you can, as a halfback, you look up and you make a decision, you're scanning. When it's slippery at night, you catch the ball like this, which then doesn't give you enough time to look and scan. You can't move the ball laterally. So my idea is to have a different ball at night with more pronounced nipples, dimples, where you can actually grab hold of the ball and it sort of sticks to your hands more. Now, the downside of this would be the kickers would jump up and down, goal kickers. Oh, it's harder to kick, but... Does anyone go to the game to watch people kick goals? No. They go there to see expensive footy. So I think we should challenge Steedon to sort of come away. Now, I remember looking at a water polo ball. You know, it's played in the water. And you can get hold of that ball. It doesn't matter how slippery it is. So I think it's something we may should look at and experiment with. But the balls are fantastic now, like different to the leather balls. Sonny, are you with me? Well, it doesn't matter when you...
When you've got mitts like that, you're...
When you've got mitts like that. Right. But it's just something. And Gal made a really good point. When it's raining and peeing down raining, it's not too bad. It's quite sticky and tacky. But the nights, when it's dewy, that's when it gets really slippery, and which we saw tonight to start with. The second half, when the rain came down, it didn't look too bad. But anyway, kids at home, don't worry about those hands. Look at those things there.
Brad, are you still there, mate?
Oh, that's
great.
You
hear what they say?
Look at that. I can't get my eyes off you, little.
Thanks, Gary and Gail.
Yeah.
You know, the funny thing is, Matthew's got smaller hands than me.
No, really?
Yeah. My sister's got bigger hands than me, Matthew.
Yeah, wow.
Anyway, that's Cessnock 101 for the night.
That's good.
I hope all the kids
Brad
are in bed.
Are we still got Brad on the line, or is he? No,
I'm still there. No, still
oh,
there.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you.
Hey, Freddie's got tiny
do,
hands.
Do you know? Do you know how many, let's call them pimples. Do you know how many pimples there are in a ball, Joey?
No.
There's 94,000. And I've got some more information here that with the balls, and what you find is with the best quality balls, it's the most pure rubber. And that's one way where you could actually make the balls better. But it's a bit like car racing where the best rubber doesn't last as long. So at the moment, each ball that they play in an NRL game has a two-game lifespan. So I think you can actually get, like, a more pure rubber. That would mean every ball has a one-game lifespan. And one of the things that has changed is the logo. And maybe whether the logo has something to do, it's actually, I think it's... I'm not sure. The last one was Gatorade or Powerade or something, but that's the only thing that's changed on the ball. So I know we were talking earlier about different shapes and sizes and all that, but that hasn't changed nothing. So the sponsor's changed and... Yeah, the rubber's the thing that changes over the levels of football you're playing. So, you know, NRL, the rubber's pretty pure, so it only lasts two games compared to other balls you might buy from your local sports stores.
He's got the info on everything.
What about the balls you play with in rugby union, Sonny? Was there a difference?
Oh, man, I don't want to talk about this.
I was getting nervous, boy.
Sonny's cooked. He's cooked.
I'm sitting down in my tracksuit pants.
I understand what you boys are saying. We want a faster game, and, you know, having a ball that can handle those wet weather conditions would
be... dewy conditions.
Yes.
Anyway... If anyone's still out there watching, I apologise for that rank segment.